project I'm going to create a video texture material for this TV that I've placed here. Let's go to the Revit and let me to create a section box on this TV. Switch the selection with tab, and from the modify tab, click on section box, and also it will be updated on Enscape 2 that we can work with. You have two ways. The first one is to go to the family editor and place and edit the material of this part of the TV. But because the video textures are not the easiest materials that you can create with the Enscape, and also they have some adjustment that you need to do live, I recommend to create a modeling place extrusion above it and work with that. It is really better, believe me. Okay, let's go to the architecture tab, and from the component, click on component, and from here, click on modeling place. Maybe furniture would be a good idea, or electrical devices, but it does not really make any difference. I'm going to work with furniture, click on OK. Screen and click on OK too. Okay, let me create an extrusion here. From here, click on extrusion and set your work plane on this screen and pick the edge of this screen to have a good boundary for that. Now we need to modify the thickness. We just need to select it and modify the thickness from it. Maybe 0.2. Maybe it is a good number, or maybe less. Okay, it is good now. And also I'm going to create a material parameter for it. Select the extrusion, and from here, click on this bottom here and create a material for it. Maybe SC mat will work for it. SC mat, and kill it. And I want to be it, I want to this be a type parameter, so I will check the type parameter here, and also click on OK and OK. Let's go to the family type, and from here let's create a material for it. The key is here is to create your material, and it is necessary to create a generic material. Don't work with ready-to-use materials because it can cause some troubles. From here, let me name it SC mat again. It is not really necessary to put some words in this material. You can name it whatever you want. The main part of this material is in identity tab. Maybe it is strange, but you can, you should do this thing I'm going to say right now. In the description part, you need a syntax, that the syntax is like this. The syntax is like this. You can, I will put the syntax in the description too. You can copy and paste it from there. Okay, let's check the syntax. This video word is static, and you don't have to change that. But after that, all of them are dynamics, and you should change them. Let's begin with the first one, the path. For example, for this video, I'm going to use for this. Tutorial, I have this video on my screen, on my desktop. The work you should to do is to copy the path of this file. The easiest way to copy the path of one file is to hold the shift key and right click on that, and from here click on copy as path. Let's go to the Revit and let me to replace the path with this sentence here. And after that, we have two parameters, x and y. These are the factors, x for width and y for height. It is some experimental thing. You need, it is not a really good ratio and a specific ratio between your video size or video resolution and your words. You just need to make it bigger or make it smaller to fit your family. For this family, maybe if I wouldn't be wrong, maybe 2.2 and 1.48 would work. And for the rotation, you have to assign a number between 0 and 306. For this video, maybe 0 would be good and it doesn't need any rotation. And the last part and the last thing I'm going to do is to assign a surface pattern to adjust the material very easily with usage of surface pattern. You just need to go to the graphic tab and from the surface pattern in foreground, but don't forget to choose a model pattern, not drafting pattern. And from here, I'm going to use the smallest font, 100 millimeter squares, and click on OK and OK. But I forgot something. In pass, when you copy the pass, it will have two symbol from in the start and in the end. You need to delete them. Otherwise, it wouldn't work for you. Okay, it is good now. Click on OK, OK, and finish. Now, when we go to the Enscape, we can see our material is duplicated. You can see from here in height. Let me choose the surface pattern here. Click on Edit in Place and press Tab, and let me move it a little bit down to see the results. And click on Finish. Now you can see we have to make this bigger, maybe 1.5. As I said earlier, it is an experimental thing, not a static one. Let me change these to maybe 1.5. Click on OK and apply. You can see it is better now, but I need to adjust the material again. Select the extrusion and select also the surface pattern and move it up a little bit. Click on Finish. Maybe more. You can use Move tool also. Click on Finish. Also, we need to make it bigger too. But I'm not going to do more adjustment here, and you can get the point from the tutorial, and you can also adjust it very easy. The second thing I'm going to tell you is the light of this and lighting of this TV in the night. Let me clear the section box and let me show you the results when it will be at night and the lighting of this video. Let's change the time of the day and let's see the result when it will be at night. Hold shift key and with the right click let's change the time of the day. It doesn't have any lighting here because in the material properties we didn't add any self-illuminance and any we didn't add any lighting to it. Let's select the extrusion from here in the material tab. Let me add some self-illumination to it, and let me put it on maybe LED screen or CTR television. LED screen, and also for the color temperature, it would be on TV screen. Okay, this is okay. Click on OK and OK. and wait a moment until Enscape would update the lights. Now you can see we have a better TV with some illuminations too. Don't forget to choose the LED screen and TV screen, because maybe when you select other kind of things, you would get some